Feline hyperesthesia syndrome is also known as twitching, rippling, or rolling skin disease. That's because the presentation of the disease causes the skin to move in a way that looks like the cat is feeling that there's an insect crawling on his back. The condition is still poorly understood, and it might actually be a combination of more than one cause, or might be a result of completely different causes that just have the same presentation. I'm Dr. Orion, a veterinarian and a veterinary behavior residency graduate. Here are the causes and the clinical signs for hyperesthesia syndrome, but stick around to learn about the diagnosis and the treatment. It can be dermatological, like everything that causes skin issues, for example, fleas or a skin infection. It can be neurological, like brain tumors, slip disc, anything in the spine, the brain, or in the neurons, in the nerves themselves. It can be caused by everything that causes pain or discomfort. And of course, it can be behavioral. Not all cats will have all of the clinical signs. So don't look for all of them. Look for even just some of them. Even just one. Pacing, agitation, leave me alone, vocalization, meow, 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 excessive licking of the back, the legs, the tail. You got me. I'm not gonna try to do that. And even biting of self or having redirected aggression towards other people or other pets. Some cats will even be sleeping when all of a sudden they will jump up, start running around, vocalizing, maybe even defecating, and maybe go into hiding. And all of that without any observable trigger. Sometimes petting the cat or touching the cat will be the trigger, but many times it will happen even if there's no one around the house. You should try and video record your cat alone and see if it happens then as well. Of course, as the name implies, sometimes you will see the skin on the back of the thorax of the rib cage or the back of the abdomen rolls. And sometimes you might also see the muscles of the back kind of tenses up. But despite of the name, this doesn't always happen. The diagnosis is made by collecting the information about when this phenomenon is most likely to happen and what exactly is seen when it does. According to the history, much more advanced diagnostics may be done, for example, blood work, x-rays, skin cytology, and you might even be referred to a specialist like a neurologist or a dermatologist, or of course, a behaviorist. Another option that is sometimes used in order to diagnose the problem is to do a medication trial. Basically, that means that we will start treating, for example, skin issues, or we will start treating seizures and see if the cat responds. If the cat does respond, it means that it's more likely to be that problem. If the cat doesn't respond, then we rule out that problem as the cause. So for example, if we treated a skin issue and the cat didn't respond by getting better, it's less likely to be a skin issue. How do we treat hyperesthesia syndrome? That depends on the cause. I will let my fellow veterinarians explain how to treat it, if it's neurological or if it's pain or if it's dermatological. But this is how you treat it if it is behavioral. First, it's always a good idea to reduce the stress and anxiety as much as you can. Next, there are a few medications that were suggested as a treatment for this specific disease. Anti-anxiety medications like fluoxetine or Prozac and clomipramine were used to treat this problem. Other medications that have anti-seizure properties as well as behavioral properties like anti-anxiety properties are clonazepam and gabapentin. Gabapentin can actually also help with neuropathic pain. So that is why many times this is my drug of choice and it will be my first trial. If you got to this point of the video, I would really appreciate if you could share the love with me by clicking the like and the subscribe button That way YouTube will show this video to more people with cats with hyperesthesia. They want to learn as well as you do, right? Help them out! You might also be interested in this video about what to do if your cat's hyperesthesia syndrome is getting worse. Check it out!